In our today's tutorial, we have a part two of linear programming, that is extracting inequalities from a passage or using given conditions, and then we are going to plot them, put them on the Cartesian plane. Of course, also finding out the wanted region. If you are new to this channel, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell there so that whenever we post a new video, you are notified. Let us quickly dive in into our tutorial. So we have a sample question that is the one you are seeing there. And this question reads, Makweo prepares two types of sausages, Hungarian and beef, daily for sale. She prepares at least 40 Hungarian and at least 10 beef sausages. She prepares not more than 160 sausages altogether. The number of beef sausages prepared are not more than the number of Hungarian sausages. It is very much important that you read out the entire passage, the entire question, before you begin to extract your inequalities. After you are done with the passage, if it is not given in the passage where the quantities, what are they represented with, or which variables or which letter are representing your quantities, you come to the first question. In this case, the first question is saying, given that X represents the number of Hungarian sausages and Y the number of beef sausages, write four inequalities. Now, since we've known to say X is for Hungarian, Y is for beef sausage, our first inequality, we're going to get it from the second question. I'm sure you're able to see where I'm highlighting there. So it is saying, she prepares at least 40 Hungarian sausages. I'm sure you remember, at least simply means to that particular number or above. So the sign we used was a greater than or equal to. Now, what type of sausage am I representing? Come back to the question here. We are saying Hungarian. So Hungarian is represented by what? X. So we say X greater than or equal to how many? 40. So this will be our first inequality. I hope you are following there. So you can see our inequality on my right hand corner there. Okay, then the second inequality is at least 10 beef sausages. Again, the at least has been used. Different quantity here now, beef, and beef is represented by Y. So we'll say Y greater than or equal to 10. That is our second inequality, and you can see it there. Our third inequality, she prepares not more than 160 sausages altogether. So X and Y, they are representing number of sausages for different types of quantities of sausages. So X, I simply mean the number of sausages that are Hungarian. Y is representing the number of sausages which are beef. Okay, so now when we add these two, here the condition is they should not be more than 160. So I'll say X plus Y, when I add these two, they should not be more than 160. Come back to our condition, not more than. If you look at this phrase here, not more than simply means less than or equal to. So our inequality here will be X plus Y less than or equal to 160. And you are done there. The last inequality, which is the fourth one, the number of beef sausages prepared are not more than the number of Hungarian sausages. What first quantity has been used? Beef. And beef is represented by what? Y. So here we have Y, not more than, remember, less than or equal to. Equal to what? Not more than Hungarian. So the Hungarian is represented by X. So the last inequality is y less than or equal to x. And you are done like that. So question B is saying, using a scale of 2 centimeters to represent 20 sausages, on each or on both axes, draw the x and y axes for 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 160 and 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 160 respectively, and shade the unwanted region to show clearly the region where the solution of inequalities lies. Again, another 4 marks. Let us jump in into our graph paper. Okay, as you can see, this is my graph paper for me. I hope you've also gotten your graph paper there where you are. Now, I want you to remember the 2 scales that we've been given. I've written them on top here, I'm sure you're able to see. So the scale for X and the scale for Y. Those scales, they are very important because they will help you where to end from. If you remember, the scale is saying, using what? Good. Using 2 centimeters to represent 20 sausages on both axes. Your graph paper you are holding in your hands there, with my graph paper you are seeing here, a bigger box. So for me, a bigger box, this bigger box right here, is 2 centimeters. So if you know that this is 2 centimeters, of course you've known to say, on the 2 centimeter box, I need to represent what? 20 sausages. So I cannot write 20 here at the beginning, 20. No, I write a 20 after I make a step, because that's when the 2 centimeters will be made. So this part here is a 0. Then when I make a step to here, this becomes 20, then 40, because you're adding 20 plus 20, 40. 40 plus 20, you're going to 60, just like that. You do the same in the y-axis. And remember, our scales are saying we are going up to positive 160 in the y, and then we're going again up to positive 160 in the x-axis. Let us align our scale quickly. Okay, so that is that. So 20, 40, 60, and we are going up to 160. So we are done in the x-axis. Now we're going in the y-axis. Again, the same thing, we're going up to 160. And you can see, I've even represented, drawn the lines nicely for X and also for Y, and I've written this is Y axis, and this is X axis. So all the questions we are solving on this question, we are writing them on the graph paper. So we need to write down, when you extract one inequality there, where do you put it on your graph paper? So you can write them on your top right-hand corner or on your left-hand right corner. That is fine. Just make sure you put the question number and also the number for your inequality. My question, that is 11A, you can see there. The first inequality was x greater than or equal to 40. I'll write them down just there. Now, let us begin. The first inequality, x greater than or equal to 40. First part, you need to identify what type of a line you are going to draw, and you need to identify where to shade. Remember, the question is saying we are supposed to shade the unwanted region. We have to shade the unwanted region. So looking at this question, x greater than or equal to 40. If you remember in part 1 we said, because of the equal sign on the greater than there, because of that equal sign, it simply means our line we're going to use will be a bold line. It means the points starting from your line, they are also part of the solution. So in this case, the x. So for us to plot this inequality, as you can see, x, we'll say x equals to 40. And we'll come back on the x-axis here. The plotting the values for x, it's a vertical line. Vertical goes like this. Okay, this is vertical. For x values, vertical. Y values, the line should go like this. So in this case, it is x. X is equal to 40. So where there is 40, you're going to draw a vertical line. So there on your graph paper, where there is 40, draw a vertical line. In this case, my 40 is here. So I'll draw a vertical line. You're able to see that red line there. That is for x equals to 40. Now, I've drawn a bold line. Why? Because on my sine, there is equal sign there. It means all the points on this line, they are part of a solution. Remember that. Come back again. Because it is a greater than sign that has been used. Now, this is a vertical line. This vertical line has got the right-hand side and the left-hand side. Of course, in the first video, I might have not mentioned it. Okay, because this one has no above part and the below part. So on your vertical lines, the vertical lines, you get me clearly. On your vertical lines, you're going to be considering this thing. The left-hand side of this line is facing the negative. The right-hand side of this line is facing the positive. So the side which is facing the positive, this side here is a greater than sign. The side which is facing the negative is a less than sign. So if you come back to your inequality, because this sign is greater than, the sign is telling you where the wanted is. In this case, where is the greater than? On my right. So on this line here, the right hand side is where my wanted is. I don't shed the wanted, I shed the unwanted. So where do we shed? We shed on our left hand side. So in this case, our line here, we're going to shed where? On your left hand side. Is it clear there? Good. Let us come to our second inequality, which is y. We are also writing it in this form. Y equals to 10. We are drawing a straight line in horizontal like this. Now come back to your graph paper. You are representing 20 in the 2 centimeter box. Where can you get the 10? So for you to get a 10 here, you're just going to divide the units you are representing with the number of lines in this box. So I'm representing a 20, I'll divide it by a 10. Okay, so if you divide there by a 10, you're going to have what? A 2. So each smaller line there is representing 2. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and then you're going to find the 10th line. So that line where you're going to find as your number 10, that is a line for y equals to 10. So for me, I'll approximate, it means halfway of this 20 here in the y-axis. You can see, again, I've drawn a bold line. Why? Because there's still an equal sign. Then coming back, where is the wanted? The wanted for this line here, because it is a greater than, so the wanted is above my line. Where do I shade? I shade below, because that is where the unwanted is. So you shade below there. Correct. Then we come back to the third inequality. Now I've interchanged, if you notice here, I've interchanged the two inequalities. Okay, the third one I've made it to be the last. Why? I'll explain. So the fourth inequality, it is also easier to plot. Now this one, we are saying y less than or equal to x. We are comparing between two quantities there. Now such an inequality, for you to plot it, it's very simple. Because this type of an inequality will be passing through the origin. Where is the origin? Just right here where there is a zero. This is where your line will be passing through. Of course, they'll have different ways on how they are going to be slanting. depending on the, some quantities there, the coefficients. So in this case, because the coefficient of x is 1, points on the origin connecting all those points like that. So my line will be like how? That would be my line there. So this line you are seeing here is a line y equals to x. Now the x is positive there. Take point of that. If the x is negative, it will slant on the negative part of x. If the x is positive, slanting on the positive part of x, just like it has slanted there. Okay. Let us come back again. Now, in this case, it is a less than or equal to sign. Less than sign. Less than simply means what? The wanted is where? Below my line. Okay, it is below my line. Where do I shade? I have to shade the unwanted. So the unwanted is above. In this case, this line which is slanting, above here it is unwanted. That is where I will shade. So you shade like that. Then the last inequality, which is x plus y, less than or equal to 160. Now, if you have an expression like this one, you need to draw a table of value. Make sure you remember that point. When you have x and y, we are adding two quantities and then we formulate an inequality like this one.
We are now going to draw a table of value that will help us to plot this inequality. Make sure you always do that with such inequalities. So our table of value is going to be in this form. So this table of value, you make sure you draw it on your graph paper. So the first part is going to have x, the second slot down there is going to have y. Now, you can see how many, so six slots. Now, here, the diagonal, the major diagonal, using your right hand, that is the major. In the major diagonal here, for linear programming, just put zeros. So we're going to put a zero here and a zero here. So the zero in the x and the zero in the y. Now we need two values. We need now the values in the minor diagonal. So these are corresponding values. I will get my equation, the x plus y less than or equal to 160. Now here, we are going to insert, the first part is x is equal to 0. So we are going to insert, where you are seeing x on this equation here, where you are seeing x, we are going to substitute with what? We are going to substitute with the 0. So we'll put a 0 here,
plus y, less than or equal to 160. Now, if you look at the way it is here, if this zero crosses the equal sign there, is it going to make any difference? Of course not. So here, our answer will just be y equals to 160. It will be the same with x. If I put a zero on my y here, I'll still have x equals to 160.
Since now we are now clear on how to go about it, so I'll put it on my graph paper now. So that is the table of value. Now those calculations we are doing, they are supposed to be on your graph paper. Make sure you calculate them from there. Alright, so this is our table here. Now we have our values for the first one here. This is 0, 160. Then the second point is 160, 0. We are going to plot these points on the Cartesian there. So 0, 160, 0 in the x-axis, 160 in the y, it is just here. So this is where my point is. Then 160, 0, 0 in the y-axis. So 0 in the y-axis is right here. Then 160 in the x-axis is right here. So this is where your point is. You plot like that on your graph paper.
Now, once you are done like that, you are going to connect those 2 points you have plotted on the Cartesian. Connect them with a straight line. Come back to your inequality. Again, there's an equal sign, so you are drawing a bold line. So get your ruler and draw a straight line connecting this point and this point here. So here is my line there. Where is my wanted region? What sign has been used here? A less than sign. So less than simply means your wanted is where? Below your line. So this slanting line here, the wanted is below here. Where do I shade? I'm supposed to shade above because that is where the unwanted is. So we are shading above that line like that. We are done with that question. I hope it is clear. The C question is saying, the profit on the sale of each Hungarian sausage is 3 kwacha 00 ngwe, and on each beef sausage is 2 kwacha 0 ngwe. How many of each type of sausages are required to be prepared to make maximum profit? Remember, we said linear programming is all about maximizing the profit for your business. Okay, so now look at this. So after selling one, there's a profit of 3 kwacha. On the beef sausage, there's a profit of 2 kwacha. Now, this person wants to find out how many of each type, how many Hungarian sausages is he going to make? How many beef sausages are they going to be there so that this person can make a maximum profit? So from here, you're going to formulate an equation. Don't forget that. You will form a what? An equation. So from here, we'll multiply. Since this 3 is the profit on the Hungarian, so we'll multiply the 3 times x, and we're going to have 3x. Plus the 2 times y, we're going to have 2y. So this is the equation that we are going to use for us to find out how many of each type this person is going to make. So coming to the C question here on the graph paper, I've written the question number here. So C, I have 3x plus 2y. You can see that. The 3 is the profit on each Hungarian sausage. So I'll multiply with the number of sausages there. Now, for you to answer this question, this is what you're going to be doing to find out how many of each type. You will come back to your inequalities where your lines for your inequalities are intersecting. Now, you take note that you only consider the point of intersections that are on the boundary for your wanted region. Don't follow anything else. They might intersect somewhere else, but follow the boundary of your wanted region. So in this case, my wanted region is here. So I'll not go beyond this part here. I cannot take this point here. Why? Because it is beyond my wanted region. So I'll pick points. I'll pick a point here. Okay, so I'll pick a point on this point here, on this part here. I'll pick a point on this intersection part here. I'll pick another point here. I'll pick another point here. So I have only 4 points of intersections that are within the wanted region. You can see the arrow there. So let us pick the points. Now, these points, you don't have to start writing them there on this question where you're finding how many of each type. So you'll get your calculator quickly and start punching which ones are going to give you the maximum profit. This point here is a 40,40. I'm sure you're able to see, even on your graph paper, it should be able to give you the same. So this point here is a 40,40. So already we have a 40,40. So 40,40. So these are the points that you have. Within these points, the x values, they are representing the number of Hungarians. So if I say 80 here, I simply mean those are 80 Hungarian sausages. The next 80 here is the 80, meaning the beef sausages that are in the y-axis. All right, so I'm sure you are following me there. Okay, so we proceed. So when you continue with your question, now you find out that the 150, 10, which is this point right here, the 150, 10 will be the one that will give you the maximum profit. How? When you put the 150 on the x, you have 3 multiplied by 150. Okay, 3 multiplied by 150. Then you are going to have, again, 2 multiplied by 10. When you add those, you find that you are getting the maximum profit. That is your answer. So in this case, we'll say we have this person needs 150 Hungarian and 10 beef sausages are needed. That is all. That is your answer there. The last question is saying calculate this maximum profit. So what we did now on the C question, we are just punching on the calculator without showing the method. On the last question now, they want us to calculate. So exactly what we've done on the C, now we'll just show the method and the actual profit this person is making, or the maximum profit. So in this question, we are still using the same equation, that is 3x plus 2y. Now we'll substitute 3 multiplied by 150. I'm using the same points that are giving me maximum. So 3 multiplied by 150 plus 2 times 10. And when we multiply 3 times 150, we're having, okay, good, 450 plus 2 times 10, that is a 20. 20 plus 450, we're having what? 470. So you're right to say the maximum profit is 470. So
if you are using a graph paper, your question will look like this. It should be able to look like this. So thank you very much, guys, for watching up to the end of this video.